Form books, tutorial chapter one. You are the assistant accountant of Tom's nursery, a business growing plants and selling them to local garden centres. The finance director has been asked to produce some information analysing the quarterly costs of the business as part of the possible cost restructuring programme. She wants you to complete categorising the costs into variable, semi-variable and fixed costs. Save the spreadsheet file in the appropriate location, rename it as MATST, Chapter 1 Activity Answers. So I'm going to go File, Save As, go to wherever I want to save it, and call it Match Chapter 1 Activities Answer. I'm going to call it Answer 1. Alright, I like to have my instructions on the left and the spreadsheet on the right, so I'm going to go View, New, View, Arrange All, Vertical. Then I can have my spreadsheet on the right, the instructions on the left, and I can do everything together at the same time. So task one says merge and centre Tom's nursery, heading across C and D, change the font to 13. So there's Tom's nursery, C and D, home, merge and centre, font, I want 13, but you can see 13's not there, so I'm going to click, type 13, enter, and it's taken form. Number two, say merge and centre the quarter ended 30th of June 25, heading across C and D, change the font to bold and size 12. So there it is, C and D, font 12, bold, make sure they're active, and merge and centre. It's now saying spell check the information on activity one spreadsheet. So I'm just going to go there. I'm going to click on review, spell check, ABC. It's saying that I've spelt categories wrong. So I'm just going to choose the one that it should be and change. It's saying I've spelt depreciation wrong. So I'm just going to change it, and now I'm good to go. It's saying, number four, use the list cost categories F2 to F4, which is over here, F2 to F4, and we want to create data validation to D6, D17. So I'm going to highlight D6 to D17, going to go to data, going to go to data validation, and click on settings. As it's a list, I'm going to click list. In the source, click on what I want, and then it's saying I need to put in an input message. Cost can only be categorized using the listed cost categories. So and then it's saying choose a suitable warning if an incorrect category was typed into the cell. I'm just going to use the stop, and I'm going to say please select from the list provided. Click OK. So as you can see, I've got my message, and if I type something wrong, I'm going to get a warning. So what's it saying now? Number five, enter correct category of the remaining costs into the cost column category. Okay, so let's see the headings. Compost is variable. Compost pots, variable. Depreciation, fixed. Depreciation of office equipment, fixed. Fixed higher cost of delivery lorries plus charge per mile. That would be semi because I'm having to pay extra. Hire of additional temporary greenhouses. That would be fixed because you'd be paying the same amount each month. Plastic pots, variable. Power to heat greenhouse standard cost per rate per kilowatt. I'd say semi-variable. Salary of administrative staff, fixed. Seed costs, variable. wages of seed planters and cultivators variable because you'd only be paying them when you need them. Okay, number six. Enter the numbers to accounting, pound sign, thousand separator, zero decimal places. So I'll highlight it. Right click format cells. I want it to be accounting, but I also want thousand separator. So number, thousand separator, accounting, pound sign, zero decimal places. It's now saying sort the data into variable, semi-variable and fixed costs. So I'm going to highlight what I want and I'm going to go home, and I like custom sort, so I'm going to go to editing, custom sort. It's column D, so I'm going to choose column D, and as I want variable first, I'm going to do Z to A. So I should get variable at the top, semi-variable, then fixed. It says ensure all data text is visible, so I'm going to go to the magic triangle, click between A and B to make sure. Number 9, delete column B. So I'm going to click on B, right click, delete. It's also saying delete row 5, so right click, delete. It's now saying use a subtotal to sum each type of cost, including a grand total. So I'm going to go to data, outline, subtotal. I wanted to do, where are you, cost. So I'm going to choose cost category. I want sum and I want actual cost because that's the only one with the figures in it. So I'm going to click OK and I've got my grand total. I think there's an error there, it's saying B21, but because we deleted row 5, it will be going to B20. It says highlight the grand total with a total border. So, home. And font. And I want a total border. Top and bottom. Okay, it's now saying hide the detailed cost information so only the subtotals by cost and category are showing. So I only want the subtotal. So you've got 1, 2, 3. Hide the detailed cost information so that the amount and subtotal. There we go. And then it says hide column A. So I'm going to click on column A, right click and hide. And there we have it. Save your worksheet. Chapter 1 is now complete.